the station working for you, this is WRTV News at 11, streaming now.
Good evening to you here at 11 o'clock. Millions just finished watching President Donald Trump and former Vice President Joe Biden go head-to-head in the first of three presidential debates. We'll show you some of the big moments a little later, but first, WRTV's Cornelius Hawker spoke with two voters on opposite sides of the aisle about the issues that matter to them and where the country goes after the election.
Despite the attention being given to the first presidential debate, most people have already made up their minds about who they're going to vote for. That's according to a Pew Research poll that showed only 5% of Trump or Biden supporters said their minds could be changed. I talked to two guys whose votes won't be changed because of this debate.
I hope that Americans are reminded why they hired Donald Trump.
President Trump is not interested in leading us through this.
Alex Totten is supporting Biden because he says Trump's first term has been filled with misstep after misstep. Top of mind is his handling of the coronavirus pandemic. An estimated 206,000 Americans have died from COVID-19 since March.
You know, Vice President Joe Biden has a plan day one to turn around the country when it comes to coronavirus, when it comes to COVID-19. What we need is a complete change. We need a complete change of leadership because there's been a failure of leadership.
But Jeff Commons feels the opposite and points to major achievements from the Trump administration as to why.
Tax cuts, regulatory reform, trade negotiation and renegotiation, deals that hadn't been looked at in decades, strict constructionist judges and likely a third Supreme Court appointee, strength abroad and a stronger military.
Both men are firmly planted on different political sides. So I pose this question to them. What happens if the candidate they don't support wins in November? How do we bring Americans together?
It's been a heated few years, rhetorically speaking. And so I think each side will need to have a little grace, and I hope we can find our way there.
It would take a lot of strength and a lot of emotional strength to come together and just keep working and keep grinding and making those small changes.
Working for you, Cornelius Hawker, WRTV.